Jericho was tightly shut up because of the children of Israel. None went out, and none came in. And the Lord said unto Joshua, See, I have given into thine hand Jericho, and the king thereof, and the mighty men of valor. And ye shall compass the city, all ye men of war, and go round about the city once. Thus shalt thou do 6 days. And 7 priests shall bear before the ark 7 trumpets of ram's horns. And the 7th day ye shall compass the city 7 times, and the priests shall blow with the trumpets. And it shall come to pass that when they make a long blast with the ram's horn, and when ye hear the sound of the trumpet, all the people shall shout with a great shout, and the wall of the city shall fall down flat, and the people shall ascend up every man straight before him. For the Lord hath said unto Joshua, Shout, for I have given you the city.
The inhabitants of Jericho were perverted by sin and corrupt, surrounded by walls so thick that chariots raced on top, with ladders, catapults, and spearheads readied and blazing in the sun. The armies of Israel stood waiting for commands of war to come. For 39 years, Joshua was trained under Moses' righteous hand. And it was Joshua who led nearly 3 million Israelites into the promised land. Now Moses was dead and the real test came. Could he simply follow God's word and do something that to the natural mind would be utterly absurd? Without Moses to ask advice of or an advisory committee, God said, the walls will fall. Just tell them, shout, for I have given you the city. Now God was putting in operation a principle of war, setting at our disposal weaponry that drops demons to the floor. Something with tremendous power that assassinates fear and doubt. It's the high praises of victory, unleashed by a shout. When David played his songs of praise, demons fled from Saul. As Paul and Silas worship God, the chains began to fall. It lifts us above the circumstance and lets God's power flow. The shout of victory binds the devil with chains that won't let go. So with the confidence of warring angels, Israel stood stone ready to obey Joshua, speak to their mountain, and shout, for God was giving them the city. Days they marched around Jericho, and the last day they marched 7. While the Canaanites jeered from their evil walls, Israel's faith reached heaven. Before any manifestation, with every brick still in place, eyeball to eyeball, they looked fear dead in its face. They didn't wait to feel some earthquake or to see a lightning flash. They didn't need to hear a theatric rumble or a mind-blowing crash. They prepared their souls for victory. Now it's God's turn to come through. They'd scream their lungs out simply because they believed God's word was true. So, with the high praises of God in their mouths, there came a volcanic sound, and Israel shouted in victory, and they shouted in faith. And the walls came tumbling down. This is where we come in. Now, how many know the anointing breaks the yokes of the bondages of sin? Sin can't survive in the anointed, moving, spontaneous praise of man. The devil's torment and sickness can't function when we worship and when we pray. Because the church of the living God is still alive and well today. Now how many here within the sound of my voice are not ashamed of the gospel of Christ? You ready to tear down walls that have held you captive tonight? You're sick and tired of being down and out, and you want to be up and coming? You ready to ransack the kingdom of darkness and send some devils running? You ready to let some strongholds fall that have never fallen before? How many know it's not by might, nor by power, but by my spirit, says the Lord? Then in the name of Jesus Christ, I challenge you tonight, and I dare you. I said, I dare you to forget the person next to you and trials you've been in. Forget religious do's and don'ts and traditions made of men. But with a shout of victory on your lips, with praise declaring war, to leap up on your feet right now, make a joyful noise and praise the Lord! Clap your hands, O ye peoples! Shout unto God with a voice of triumph!